My vagina is a shell. A round, pink, tender shell, closing and opening, opening and closing. My vagina is a flower, an eccentric tulip, the center acute but deep, the scent delicate, the petals gentle but sturdy. I did not always know this. I learned this at the vagina workshop. I learned this from the woman who runs the vagina workshop. A woman who believes in vaginas, who sees vaginas, who helps other women see their vaginas by seeing other women's vaginas. In the first session, the woman who runs the vagina workshop asked us to draw our own unique, beautiful, fabulous vagina. That's what she called it. She wanted to know what our own unique, beautiful, fabulous vagina looked like to us. A pregnant woman who was in the workshop drew a big red mouth with gold coins spilling out of it, screaming. Another very thin woman drew a big serving plate with a sort of Devonshire pattern on it. I drew a big black dot with squiggly lines spilling out of it. The black dot was equivalent to a huge hole in space, and the squiggly lines were objects or people or your basic atoms that got caught there. I had always thought of my vagina as an anatomical vacuum, randomly sucking up things from the surrounding environment. I did not think of my vagina in practical or biological terms. I did not, for example, see it as something attached to me. Then the woman who ran the workshop asked us to look at our vaginas with hand mirrors, and after careful examination, we were to verbally report to the group what we saw. I must tell you that up until then, all that I knew about my vagina was nothing. I had never really seen the thing. It had never occurred to me to look at it. To me, my vagina existed on some abstract plane. It felt so reductive and odd. I mean, we were there on our shiny blue mats with our hand mirrors. I felt like what the early astronomers must have felt like with their primitive telescopes. I found it quite unsettling at first, my vagina. Like the first time you see a fish cut open and you discover the bloody complex world inside. It seemed so raw, so red, so fresh. And what surprised me most were all the layers. Layers upon layers opening into more layers. My vagina amazed me. I couldn't speak when it came my turn in the workshop. I was experiencing what the woman who ran the workshop called vaginal wonder. I just wanted to lay there, my legs spread, examining my vagina forever. It was better than the Grand Canyon. Ancient and full of grace, it had the freshness and innocence of a purple English garden. It was funny, very funny. It made me laugh. It could hide and seek, open and close. Then the woman who ran the workshop asked us how many of us had had orgasms. Two women tentatively raised their hands. I didn't raise my hand, but I had had orgasms. I didn't raise my hand because they were accidental orgasms. They happened to me. They happened in my dreams, and I would wake up in splendor. They happened in the water, mostly in the bath, once at Cape Cod. They happen on horses, on bicycles, sometimes at the treadmill at the gym. I didn't raise my hand because although I had had orgasms, I didn't know how to make one happen. I thought it was a mystical, magical thing. I didn't want to interfere. It felt wrong to get involved. Contrived, manipulative. It felt Hollywood. The magic would be gone, and the mystery, and then, of course, the problem was I hadn't had a magical, mystical orgasm in 2 years, and I was frantic. That's why I was in the vagina workshop. Then the moment arrived that I both dreaded and longed for. The woman who ran the workshop asked us to take out our hand mirrors again and see if we could locate our clitoris. We were there, the group of us women, on our backs, on our mats, trying to find our spots, our locus. A reason. And calmly stroked my forehead. She told me my clitoris wasn't something I could lose. It was me, she said. The very essence of me. It was both the doorbell to my house and the house itself. I didn't have to find it. I had to be it. Be it. Be my clitoris. Be my clitoris. I laid back and gently closed my eyes. I put the mirror down. I watched as I floated above myself. I watched as I approached myself and slowly began to re-enter. It was quiet, this re-entry. Quiet and gentle. I felt like an astronaut re-entering the surface of the Earth. I bounced and landed and bounced. I slid into my own blood and cells and skin, and then I slid into my vagina. It was suddenly easy and I fit. I was all warm and ready and young and pulsing and alive, and then, without looking, with my eyes still closed, I put my finger on what had suddenly become me. There was a little quivering at first, which urged me to stay. The quivering broke into a quake, an eruption, the layers dividing and subdividing, which broke into an ancient horizon of light and silence. Which broke into a plane of music, and colors, and innocence, and longing, and I felt connection, calling connection, as I lay there thrashing about on my little blue mat. My vagina is a shell, a tulip and a destiny. I am arriving as I am beginning to leave. My vagina. My vagina.